Hello student, in this video I will be teaching you the process or stages involved in communication. So the first step towards stages in communication is the sender. Now question come, who is sender? A sender is the person or group of organization who has an idea or information which they wants to communicate others. The process of communication starts with sender. So the idea or the information in the sender mind is the source of communication. Now sender is having idea, sender is having information, but when the communication can take place? Only when the sender has a wish to send the information. Only when the sender has 100% wish to communicate with the receiver, then only your communication can take place. Next is your message. Message is what? The information what the sender convey to the receiver is known as message. So whenever the message sent by the sender should be a clear message. Now sender should have a clear idea, clear information regarding the message, then only he or she can send the message properly. If the sender is having a confused idea, if the sender is having a confused information, then the message sent cannot be a proper one. So the message delivered by the sender should have a clear message without any doubts, without any confusion. Next is medium. Now sender is having an idea, sender is having information, sender is having message. Now how the sender will send the message depend upon the medium. Now how the sender wants to send the message depend upon the medium chosen by the sender. Now there are three type of medium by which the sender can send the information. The first is your oral. Oral is a form of spoken. So by the help of spoken form the sender can send the message, or by choosing electronic means. Electronic means fax, email, telephone, these are refers to as electronic mean. So again the sender can send their information by the help of electronic means. Or the last medium is your paper base. Paper base, by the help of paper base the sender can send the information. Paper base is like letters, notice, memos, poster. So the sender can choose any one among this medium and can send their information. Next is your encoding. What is encoding? The process of translating meaning of message into suitable word, symbol, gesture is known as encoding. So the receiver is encoding, translating the meaning of the message or information or idea in the simplest way so that the receiver can understand is known as encoding. Next step towards stages of communication is the receiver. Now receiver again plays an important role in the process of communication. Now sender is there, message is there, he has selected the medium, he has translated the idea or information in the simplest way. So the next is the receiver. So the sender sends the messages to the receiver. Now receiver is a person who understand the message and give replies to the sender. Sixth is the decoding. Decoding means when the receiver gets the message and attaches its own meaning so that they can understand the idea or information given by the sender is known as decoding. So the receiver, who decodes the message? Receiver decodes the message. So last step is your feedback. Again, feedback is given by the receiver. After receiving the message, the receiver decodes, attaches its own meaning, simplifies the information, and then understand the real meaning of the message is known as understanding of real meaning of the message and then give asking questions or giving replies to the sender is known as your feedback. Now, feedback is a tool by which the sender can understand whether the receiver has understood the information, the idea given by him. If there is no feedback, means the communication has failed. So feedback plays a vital role in the process of communication. So now we will sum up the process or stages involved in communication is sender. Sender is a person who sends the message. Now message is the information which the sender wants to convey to the receiver. Medium is by the tool or the vehicle through which the sender wants to send the message. Fourth is your encoding. Encoding means attaching the simplest meaning to the complex information or idea. Fifth one, the receiver. Receiver plays another important role. Without receiver, communication cannot take place. Decoding, what the receiver understand from sender's information idea, that is your decoding. And what is feedback? The replies given by the receiver to the sender is your feedback. So student, if you are having any doubt, you can call me. Thank you.